did something of mine. Like you deserved a revenge. Like I got something to hide. I'll keep on playing with you. You keep on calling me names. So I can take the abuse. It's just a game. Oh, you left a hole in me. But I don't cut easily. I'm only just holding up on my knee. I think it's time to open up. Don't make me bleed. So turn it on. We can go wild. It's what you want.
Cowboys and Falcons on EA Sports as we come to you from Atlanta, Georgia for today's game.
Phil, we've got a couple of the best tight ends in the game on each sideline today, and they could be the difference makers.
You know, these tight ends, they can do it all. They're tremendous blockers for the running game. They got the speed to go down the field, and they got feet, Jim. You know, those quick feet, so they run those short routes. If there's man-to-man coverage, they're quick enough and shifty enough to still get away from the defender.
the Falcons from the 22.
Matt Ryan with the long pass down the field.
At wideout, one of the biggest threats in the game, Julio Jones.
Nobody second-guessing the Atlanta Falcons hierarchy now, are they? All those draft picks they gave up for Julio Jones a couple years ago looks like a pretty smart move now.
Second down and 10. Tammy, the target. Tammy's brought down after picking up 6 on this play.
Good job by the quarterback that time. Makes the decision. Throws it short and does not get the first here. Then having third and long.
Third down and 4. And incomplete. What a hit that time.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football is arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
Matt Bosher ready to punt. And it's a fake. They're running a fake. An open lane.
How about that play? The punter can do more than just kick it. He can throw it too. He is a very good athlete. That was a nice throw.
They come to the line and it's first down. Falcons break huddle and show a jumbo look. And now Ryan's going to take off. Off the mark. As we take a look at the defense for the first time today, these starters in the secondary will be challenged today in both the passing and running games. The Falcons will take the snap from the 35. Tammy on receiving end. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, I think early in the game, anytime you cross the 50-yard line, it just gives you confidence that what you're doing is going to work today. Let's see if they can take advantage of that and take it on down into the end zone.
First and 10. Down the field. Roddy White going to take it home for the touchdown. And with that touchdown, they grab the lead here early in the first.
Boy, it's always nice to jump out to lead the football game. It just takes pressure off of you. And what it does, it puts the pressure on the other team. A good spot after scoring that touchdown.
The Falcons with the PAT to come. Driving extra point is good. He's got a chance to return this one. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. First down at the 27. Takes the hit, throws. As we set now the offensive lineup, one of the most physical wideouts in the league is Dez Bryant.
I think he's one of the best wide receivers in the NFL. Dez Bryant can catch the football. He can break tackles. He's so competitive. If you cover him, he can still beat you up and get the football. That's what you like to see from a wide receiver.
And now on first down, we'll go back to the air. The hit knocks the ball out incomplete. This defensive lineup is anchored by the 340-pound presence of defensive lineman Paul Solei.
6'4", 340 pounds. And I'm telling you, you look at him, you think, oh, he weighs about 280 pounds. That's how in shape he is. Every defense needs inside presence, and Paul Soliai will give it to you.
Tony Romo uncorks the long pass.
Coming to the line at the 33.
This play set up by the long gainer.
Halfway through this first quarter now to Williams. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Williams has really hit hard that time. And I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
Second and 10.
Romo to Witten. Gets about 9 on the play.
Third and 1.
Hand off by Romo.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Beasley's marked down at the 19. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. It's caught by Cole Beasley. Allen's in on the tackle.
Nice job that time by the offense getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm, because you got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
Ready to make the stop on the goal line. Loading up that defensive front. Looking to go up top again on first down. Knocked down as he fires it. Marching down the field and taking their time.
Second and goal from the 1. Brings it in for the score in the end zone. And it looks like we'll be going into quarter number 2 with a tie game on our hands, partner.
Yeah, a tie game going into the second quarter. Looks like it's going to be an exciting day. And listen, that's what we always love up here, isn't it? We love exciting games that stay close. And this one has the looks of that.
The Falcons in kick return formation.
Hester. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
The Falcons heading back onto the field on offense. They scored on their last drive, Phil, and they did it with a blistering aerial attack.
Quarterback is hot. He is getting protected. Oh, man, what do you do now? I think if you're an offensive coordinator, it doesn't matter what you call. You know your guys are going to make it work.
Falcons all bunched up here as they get set at the line. It's caught by Tammy. Carr's there to take him down.
Playing press coverage to the outside. First and 10.
Late in the first, and it looks like the offense now has a great opportunity to break the tie.
Yeah, now it's time to go out there and get something done. My gosh, you practiced all week. You know, I kept hearing from the coaches, and so did you, Jim, how good they looked in practice on the offensive side. Well, show it to me.
The Cowboys have it at the 34. Jason Witten with the catch. A foot race to the end zone. The 10. Trufant's there to make the tackle.
What a good throw and catch by the quarterback and receiver. Look at the speed, but hey, good hustle by the defense. Tackling right before he gets into the end zone.
Goal line defense on the field. Back to the air here on first down to Williams.
Touchdown, Dallas.
As we get near the end of the opening quarter, they've grabbed the lead with that touchdown.
Yeah, things have been rough so far, haven't they? It's been fun to watch. Each team is being very competitive and physical, but that's a nice thing to do, to score that touchdown and get a lead here late in the first.
The Cowboys getting ready to kick it away. Hester's going to test the coverage this time. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Falcons just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches, look, you make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you got to be smart, you got to be efficient, and get the job done.
It's intercepted!
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Cowboys come out for the next possession, having reached the end zone on each of their two previous drives.
Yeah, it's been good stuff to watch, no doubt. You know, the offensive side, the offensive coordinator is right in tune with the quarterback to call exactly the plays that need to be called because of the situations, and the quarterback has been hot throwing the football.
First down here after the completion. Jackson wraps up the quarterback.
What a good scheme that time by the defense. They confuse the offense. They blitz. They don't know who to pick up. And how about the defender? They must love this. Coming in free and gets a good clean shot on the QB and gets a sack.
The Falcons defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
On his way.
Touchdown! They continue to pour it on early in the second quarter with yet another touchdown here, Phil.
Well, I hope the defense learned a little something on that drive. The way they are playing is not working. So you are allowed to blitz in this league. You can take a chance. That's what I suggest. Get after it. Be more aggressive and blitz that offense.
Perhaps the best ever. Hester on the return. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Falcons offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Room to work. Rondo McClain, who makes the stop.
Look what the defensive line is doing. They're all pinching down inside. They're expecting a run.
First down at the 31. Ball was out. They recover their own fumble. They bring him to the turf.
One thing coaches hate when their offense is on the field is fumbling the football, because a lot of times it's just bad fundamentals. But they're lucky this time they had the fumble. They're able to get on top of it.
The Cowboys with a nickel look here on defense. Jacob Tammy has the catch. The Falcons want to get their tight end involved early, and they have. Tammy's been a big target, and he's making some big plays.
Boy, he is making some big plays. And any time when you have a tight end good, and just remember this, he is the closest receiver to the quarterback, so his chances of catching the football, they go up, and he's taking advantage of it.
Comes away with it.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to pack it up.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Tammy, the target.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity right on target.
Falcons will take the snap from the 35. Two hands on the football and has the catch. First down at the 28. The sack of the quarterback by Greg Hardy.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad after getting sacked like that by the defensive end. Your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
The Falcons take it from the 38. Looking long. And he knocks the ball out of his hands.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, they can make a big play.
The Cowboys' defense now is going to go nickel. The defense gets the sack.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
The Falcons take it from the 43. Launching it deep. And intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
I got that. Be more in me, yeah, that's my problem. Whoa, whoa. I rep my city. Yep, I got 'em. What you heard? Be wildin'. You got me. I'm from the bottom. Oh, yes, Lord. Walk like I'm. Talk like I'm Mackin'. The projects love me. Your boy was hatin'. I'm finna kill 'em. I'm finna kill 'em. I'm on 100, I done hit the ceiling. I'm thinking, we go for dollars. Him and my brothers keep a keeper, Nino at the Carter. They equalize them, them deeper, wiser, handsome, smarter. Man, call an ambulance, don't stand a chance to spot her. Oh, no, no, I'm out the west side, just ask my grandma. I used to move the pack, had a pack of glamour. Then ain't no cap or gamma. And now we laughing to the bank like Nana.
It's the NFL on EA Sports. Go at it as we join you from MetLife Stadium.
I don't know which team has the better tight end, but I do know that that could very well be the difference in this game today.
Well, if you made me choose between the two, I'll tell you what. I'll just say you take one. I don't care who you take. I'll take the other one because they're both that good. They can do it all. As I say, you hear me say it every once in a while. They're all in one. That means they can do anything you want.
We're underway here. Takes off from the 5. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
Zebra, zebra.
The Cowboys lined up in the nickel. The Giants from the 22. Had it, but dropped it. As we talk about the offense, Reuben Randall has gotten better every year in the league since coming out of LSU in 2012 as a second-round pick.
This is going to be a breakout year for Reuben Randall. He's big, fast, and strong. As we talk about all the time, those are great qualities, and he got better last year. Look out.
The Giants come to the line. First down marker is at the 32.
Third down and 11. Looking across the middle, he's got the catch.
The tackle is made at the 40-yard line. First down at the 40. Handoff by Manning. Second down here. From the gun. And it's swatted away. Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has the injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a Cowboys official. Right now, all they will say is it's an upper body injury and that he will not be returning. Back to you. On top of that, the staff is saying it's hard to know how long he'll be out at this point, but guys, it will most likely be an extended period of time.
The Cowboys defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Giants will take the snap from the 45. He's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Giants showing no fear this stage of the game, and they're going to go for it. The Giants take it from the 43. And the catch by Shane Vereen. And now we'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. They'll go ground. In the end, it picks up only a yard. And now they'll try over again on second down.
Vereen's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Second down and 9. The catch is made by Harris. Good yardage picked up on that call. About to snap it for the 9th play of the drive. Looks like they're in press coverage here. Now first and 10. Gets the handle here.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
This drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series. Manning's got 2 tight ends on the field for this snap. He'll throw it over the middle. Complete to Nix. Drive. Let's see how they back up the big play here. Handoff made. Gregory's all over that offense and brings him down.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
Ball is out. And Jennings is brought down.
What a big break the offense gets here. They fumble the football when they're inside their opponent's 20-yard line. They're going in to score, and somehow they come up with a fumble. Good job.
The Giants snap it at the 26. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. Should be what we call a gimme. It's a fade.
Well, I don't know what to say about that decision right there. I did not like it. Take the points, kick the field goal. You tried to be too smart, and look what happened. The pass doesn't work, and now you're in a world of trouble.
The Cowboys from the 22. McFadden's tackled down at the 24. Cowboys have it at the 24. McFadden's marked down at the 27.
third down following the run. One more snap and another quarter is in the books.
He's hit as he throws it.
Press coverage all the way.
The Cowboys from the 27. The Cowboys turn the ball over on downs.
Welcome back. We're about to get back underway here in this one.
The Giants come to the line in a tight game here in the second quarter. The score 0-0. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Jennings, left side.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Eli Manning will take it from the center here.
Here's the handoff out of the strong eye.
And Jennings is brought down. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
The Giants, they can do it all. Once they get in the red zone, they have the passes, the screens. They can throw it down to the back of the end zone. And how about that play? They can run the football right at you if they want to. And that time they picked up some good yards on that run.
Third down.
Vereen, the lone setback this time. Manning's lined up. Two tight ends set.
Did not beat the play clock. Third down after the penalty.
Set up screen to Vereen.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
This team, one of the better tackling teams in the NFL, and they play the situation perfectly. They give up the short completion. They come up and make the tackle. Now we have a fourth down.
And he puts it through for three. And they've got the advantage thanks to that field goal. Let's see if they can make the lead hold up until halftime.
Yeah, let's put a little pressure on the defense. The offense went out there. They got the job done. Got the lead, got the field goal. Now can the defense go out there and stop the other offense?
Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Cowboys back out there on offense. Their last drive, they had fourth down on their own side of midfield. They decided to go for it instead of punting the football away. We both were wondering why.
Oh, man, some people just never learn. They keep going for it on fourth down when they're in their own territory, and it always backfires. And what do you expect? Well, I know what you can expect, another loss. You just got to be smart with your decision-making when you're managing a football game.
They're going back up top. Romo connects with Williams. Taylor's in on the tackle.
Receivers get scared sometimes running that slant route. They know their linebackers inside running towards them because they're watching the quarterback's eyes.
That long gain sets them up here on this play.
And over to Witten. Gains 17.
Halftime, 2 minutes away.
Breaking huddle at the 13. Z-cat.
Staying with the passing game on first down.
To Williams. Pass is intercepted. Bryant's there to take it down.
How big was that interception right before the half, Phil?
Big time. That's all I can say. That's what it was for the situation, for your football team, and by that player, what a play he made.
Jennings got it. Screen.
We
When you see this cover two defense as a quarterback, you got to know where to throw the football. That time he did not make a good decision. You got to throw it sometimes deep down the middle. The safeties are not there. They're outside. He did not take advantage of that coverage that time.
Third down now. The Giants need to get to the 19 to pick up a first down. Manning will take the snap from the shotgun. And after only three plays, that incompletion brings us to fourth down. The Giants will punt the football.
Well, the best thing we can say about that punt return, well, he didn't fumble the football.
The Cowboys offense can reignite things now after last time moving the football only to throw a drive-ending interception.
And this is what this defense lives on. They thrive on it. They let you move the football a little bit, but they wait for that mistake. Is that mistake going to be an offensive penalty, a drop pass? That time it was an interception, so man, that's what this defense does, and they do it well.
Second down and 10. Strong eye handoff here. And they are in on McFadden.
Well, it doesn't get much worse than this, does it? You're losing the football game. Now you're looking at third and long. And look, there are no miracles in the NFL, I'll tell you that. So be smart. If the play is not there, don't force it. Dump it off and wait for the next time you get it. If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with the hurry-up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
The Cowboys take it from the 43. Williams has got it on a pass, had some heat on it. The Cowboys signal for the timeout, and that's the first one they've used. First down, offense readying for the snap. Tony Romo will take it right from the center. Romo to Witten.
Nice job that time by the runner. Gets out of bounds after the play. You got under 2 minutes, and you need to stop the clock, so he gets it done.
Romo's completion percentage, 60% on the day. This will most likely be the final play before the half ends. Romo's going to throw once again on this down.
Good job that time by the defensive player. He reads the quarterback, gets in position, down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
The kick is good. We're headed to the half here in a tight, low-scoring defensive battle. I'm sure both teams will be making adjustments offensively coming out of the half. Larry Ridley's coming up next. And the second half kicks off. Which team is going to break this tie? Steps up and fields it at the 2. And he's met head-on right there at the 20. The Cowboys come out onto the field, now looking to get something positive going here to take the lead in this game, Phil, as we start the second half.
Yeah, they would like to do that. Of course, you always want to take the lead, but when you get into the second half and you get on top, man, that starts to put the pressure on the other team. So that's their thinking. I think they will come out here and be very aggressive to start the second half.
Second and 6. Makes the catch in the open field. Witten's marked down at the 34. They hurry to the line of scrimmage. First down and 10. Romo connects with Williams. After that grab, it's now second down and 2. Playing press coverage to the outside. Throws the pass. The offense needs 2 yards here on third down following the incompletion.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing
the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
The Cowboys snap it at the 31. Had it, but the hit knocks the ball out.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
The Cowboys snap it at the 31. Locked in on the football and has hold of that in for the touchdown. And they look really sharp here in the early part of the second half with that touchdown that gives them the lead.
Yeah, you go in at halftime, you get you a cold drink, you get a little rest, and you can change your frame of mind, and we saw that. What an impressive drive by the offense.
The Giants prepared to return the kickoff. Harris elects to run it out. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Giants' offense failed to muster a single first down the last time they had it. Let's see if their offense this time can create a few sparks.
Well, you know the coaches were upset at them when they went to the sideline. So the sense of urgency is there. You should be fired up, and I expect a better drive this time.
Eli Manning will take it from the center here. First down at the 19. Gets it out for the completion. Keeps his legs moving. Has 12 on this play.
The Giants just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
First down at the 31. And that'll probably go as a drop.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
Well, it's a tight game up to this point. You got third and long. You're losing by a few points. You can't win the game on this play, but I'll tell you what, you can sure lose it. If you force this football down the field, you have a turnover, it could be the end of the game.
The Giants have to get to the 41 for a first. Odell Beckham Jr. has the ball. That's his first reception today.
This is one of those guys, when you talk about receivers, no matter what, he is always open. If the coverage is tight, don't worry. Throw it out there. He'll make a play.
First and 10. Rashad Jennings with the reception. The pass play was good for 5. Second and 5 coming up. Now the offense in the hurry up. And Jennings taking the handoff. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day. Third down on the way. The Giants have to get to the 41 for a first. Got hit on release. You start to get the sense, Phil, that they're trying to stick with this game plan offensively, and it just hasn't worked for them for more than 2 quarters now. This defense has them figured out.
The defense is all over everything, so you've got to change the sequence of play calls on the offensive side. They have not done that today, and that's why they're not having success.
The Giants don't want any part of punting the football. They're going to go for it on fourth down. The Giants have to get to the 41 for a first. They go screen with Jennings. The Giants turn the ball over on downs. A huge fourth down stop by the defense. What kind of momentum boost is that going to give them down the stretch here, partner?
Well, it's not going to hurt anything, that's for sure, Jim. And I'll just say this about their defense. It's been solid all day long. Big stop there, and it's put this team in a great position to really take control of this game.
Loss of 4 on the play. The ball is fumbled. The defense has the football. is made.
When I talk to young quarterbacks, I say the number one rule is always keep two hands on that football. That time, he doesn't do it. That's why when he got hit in the pocket, he fumbles it.
The Giants look to be almost certain to come away with points the last time they had the ball. But instead of attempting a field goal, they went for it on fourth down and were unable to convert. Let's see what they do with this possession.
Yeah, look, this isn't high school or college football where you get many, many possessions. In the pros, you don't get that many. When you get a chance to get points, you got to take advantage of it and take those points.
Coming to the line at the 30. Two tight ends on the field here. Second down and 7. He's brought down. Phil, late third quarter, and the defense gets the football back with the interception.
Yeah, it's about time, and it's time they made that play. They've been in position a few times today, and they didn't take advantage of the situation, but that time they got the right call, the right defense, and they made the play.
Witten's got it on a pass that had some heat. Ball was out. This one's going back the other way.
That is not a turnover. That is truly a takeaway by the defense. Their hustle to the football, the hard hitting, that's what got them the takeaway.
In a dangerous spot here. Backs to the end zone. Stepping up to the line at the 6. The Giants load up the backfield for this next play. He's drilled as he throws. Dropping back 3. Finds his mark. And that's a 2-yard gain.
There wasn't much there that time, so good job by the quarterback just throwing the ball and getting the catch and just getting a couple yards.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. And it's batted down. The defense again making quick work of things and setting up their offense now to extend the lead before heading to the final quarter, Phil.
What you want to do on the defensive side is beat your man that's lining up across from you. And right now they are beating their man. There's no question, and another good series for the defense.
Let's see what he can do here. Run back of about 4. The Cowboys have struggled on their previous few possessions, Phil, and are now just clinging to a slim lead.
Yeah, one of the big reasons, Jim, they've struggled so much, the offensive line just not playing as well as it did early. And look, you find an offensive line that's struggling, I'll show you an offense that's having a really hard time.
Look at that.
That's a nice play that time by the offense. Getting the first down, they're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That is a great feeling. 50-50.
Romo's completion percentage, 60% on the day. And now on first down, they'll go back to the air. To Williams. Williams got the catch and the first.
A lot of people talk about time of possession. Sometimes it's overblown, but in a situation like this, where you're winning a close game in the second half, you want to control the tempo, control the clock, keep getting those first downs.
Romo's now completed 4 in a row. One last play before the quarter end.
Pass.
The Cowboys are still in possession as we get this final quarter underway.
Nice situation here for the opposite defense.
The defense is ready to plug up the middle here on the goal line. Romo's pass will be incomplete this time.
Well, your teammates are really going to respect you after something like this. Anytime you're on that field as an athlete, and when you give all your effort to every single play like that time, how about that? Just giving every bit of effort he can to make the catch, not able to get it. And what a job of effort.
Second and goal from the 5. And it's spotted away.
When you get third goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
The defense on its heels. Football sits at the 5-yard line. third and goal from the 5. And he's forced to the ground. Players from both sides made an appeal, but the referees say it's on the defense. Third and goal to go from the 2. And it's knocked down.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
The kick is through for 3.
That field goal should make their job a whole lot easier for the rest of this fourth quarter, Phil.
Yeah, it's kind of like you and I do in the games. Everything I do, I make everything easier for you, Jim.
Harris has got it. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Giants' offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick 3-and-out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
Second down after going to the ground game the first play. They get set quickly, ready for another snap. Jennings going to take the handoff now. Now looking at third down. The Giants will look to get to the 37 to pick up a first down. Beckham is going to pull in the bullet pass.
Given you down both of the scores in the second half, you're looking for the little things to get momentum on your side. So just get a first down. Don't look for the big plays. That was a good job by the offense that time.
And now they're in their hurry up. First and 10.
Intercepted.
That brings the play to an end.
What do they do here, Phil? Off the interception, they've got the lead. Obviously, they need to run some time off the clock, and a score could possibly put this game away.
Tough situation sometimes when you get that interception right here. Do you worry about the clock or you try to score? My advice is go for it. Go down there and try to score and put this game away.
The Cowboys take it from the 38. Going to lose yards here. The Cowboys from the 37. Romo to Witten.
And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
Tight ends are becoming a bigger and bigger part in the passing offense in the NFL. It leads to a touchdown this time. Nice job by the big guy just getting in position to make the catch.
ago, I heard Run DMC on the radio. Tape deck and record, suit and velour. Pop